Já se podívám na to video.
Leaguejo v Legends.
A už je tady Jessica do p***e. To má 11 minut zase p***e, ale. Kur... Tak jdem na to, no.
Brášku, založili jsme nový kanál, kde nalezneš stará, ale i nová lore videa. Neváhej a dávej odběr.
We have a lot to cover today, including our plans for preseason, challenges and game modes. But first, let's talk about the state of the game.
Počkej, nemají to někdy s českýma titulkama? Ať tomu rozumíme. Já tomu rozumím, ale vy jste dementi a nerozumíte to. Jo, je to zajistě s českýma titulkama.
Hey,
ahoj všichni, hlásí se Safe Locked.
Safe Locked here on behalf of the league team. We have a lot to cover today.
Jak přibrala, ne?
Including our plans for preseason, challenges and game modes. But first, let's talk about the state of the game. Overall, we're pretty happy with the state of league this season.
Asi dobře platí.
Before we get into the details, let's dive into a topic that's been pretty popular lately, which is new champion balance.
Hmm?
When we look at the data, we actually see that new champions have been pretty balanced on release this year, with the exception of Dr. Mundo.
No, to je pičovina.
That said, there's more to healthy gameplay than just win rates, and we're still hearing that new champions feel unfair to play against, particularly when it comes to complex abilities or overloaded kits.
Tak.
If we're being completely honest, we don't think our champions have overloaded kits overall. But that being said, there have been times when we've given new champions.
Hrajete vůbec tu hru, kterou vole, kterou vytváříte do piči? Je to říkáte?
Too many tools and had to pull back later to give them more clear weaknesses. For example, Samira's ability to dash to allies was removed because it provided too much safety. Combined with her missile blocker, it made CCing her too difficult, especially since that's one of her main forms of counterplay. Another thing we consider when we hear a champion feels bad to play against is their intended complexity. We try to make a healthy mix of high, medium, and low complexity champions. This way, whether you like mechanical skill expression, point and click simplicity, or something in between, there's a new champion that interests you. For example, with Vex, we wanted to create a champion that was fairly easy to pick up, and we're happy to see she's hitting that mark. But beyond just how complex a champion is to play, there's also how difficult they are to understand. We want new champions to have unique gameplay, but you shouldn't need a wiki to know how to play with or against them. Hmm. Learning counterplay is a skill test we do think is important, but knowing what a champ can or can't do shouldn't be a part of it. This clarity is something we haven't always hit the mark on, especially with champions like Aphelios, who not only has a complex kit, but was also lacking UI clarity when he was released. Designing new champions is a constant balance between
making... Já jsem ještě nedočetl Aphelios'ovi ability doteď ještě.
Is something that's exciting, has clear counterplay, and isn't confusing. We're still trying to find that line, but we want to get to a spot where new champions aren't just numerically balanced, but that you all feel they're fair to play against. Beyond new champion releases, this season we've seen a wide variety of picks in every role. We've also seen a healthy improvement in diversity of playstyles across roles, especially in jungle and top lane. Some of this is due to direct champion changes, such as the kit adjustments that enable picks like
Darius,
Brand, and Morgana.
Let's go.
New items like Anathema's Change and Hullbreaker have also had a positive impact, especially in top lane where we've seen a ton of champion diversity. And finally, we know that some champion classes have been struggling after the item system update, and we've been working on some solutions to help them out.
Huh?
And this brings us to our plans for preseason. With that, I'm going to hand things off to Brightmoon, who will go more in depth on the upcoming changes.
Brightmoon. To bude pan Ananas?
Hey everyone, ne, kurva, I'm Brightmoon, the lead producer of gameplay on League of Legends.
Já jsem viděl nějaký videa tady s tím Mošvlinem, ale někdy jsem na to neudělal parodii, protože mě nic nenapadlo, co bych na to udělal.
League is like a house. Sometimes we need to do a big renovation to keep it working well.
Hmm.
Like when we overhauled the item system.
Fix the client!
We just need to add some new furniture. For this year's preseason, we're sprucing things up with improvements to our existing systems, like items, runes, and the elemental rift. Let's start with our plans for items. While some champions and classes have lots of build options, we've still got others that don't feel like they've got a mythic or legendary that really speaks to them. So we're going to be adding some new items and tweaking some others. This will include two new mythic items. The first one is a support tank item, perfect for champions that want to get aggressive and charge into the middle of a fight. When you immobilize an enemy champion, all nearby enemies will take increased damage from your team for a short period of time. The second new mythic item is built for mages who are looking for a little more survivability.
Mm-hmm.
It grants damage reduction that lingers for a few seconds after you get hit.
Table,
while the protection holds, you'll also get ability haste. We think it'll be particularly good for longer range mages who need a mythic that helps them survive a dive rather than pile on extra damage.
Ty vole, kámo, normálně Immortal Shield bow pro mage ještě. Do piči, kámo. A tohle to budou stavět, to bude zase stavět každý v té hře, každý AP champ, to bude zase broken jako kot, co? To bude jak Immortal Shield bow, který staví každý vole, piči, každý auto tak champ, no. A je jedno, že to je kedičko prostě, nebo.
When we updated League's item system, we wanted to give every champion strategic choices in every game. We still think that's the right goal for mythics, but our thinking has changed when it comes to legendary items. We think it's okay if some champions build the same legendary in most games, if it's a perfect fit. But we also want you to have plenty of options, which is why we're improving legendaries for mages, assassins, and tanks. No, for example, assassins can look forward to a new legendary item that gives ability haste, and also refunds a portion of their ultimate's cooldown with enemy takedowns. Tanks that can never get enough mana will be happy with a new legendary item that grants bonus health based on total mana, and also burns some of it to create a shield whenever they immobilize an enemy.
We'll
Finally, mages who are tired of being denied their hard-earned kills can rejoice. They'll be receiving a new legendary that grants magic pen against recently shielded enemies. As for runes,
Parada.
We think there are some good.
Takže když někdo bude mít shield na sobě, tak ten item tomu mágovi přidá magic pen. A furt to není tak silný, jako když ti Serpent Funk ten shield celý sundá, že jo, vole.
Targeted changes we need to make. Most of all, we feel the Inspiration Tree's identity has been pretty unclear. We'd like to broaden its keystone use cases. For example, we're reworking Glacial Augment to double down on its fantasy of slowing down enemies. We're also making some modifications to Lethal Tempo to lean into its attack speed fantasy, give it a more distinct use case in the Precision Tree. Up next are bounties. Champion bounties give teams who are behind a way to get back into the game without being a straight shot to victory. And this year, we're adding a second way for teams to try and make a comeback. Objective bounties will work like champion bounties, except you cash them in by taking map objectives, like towers or baron. They ramp up slowly when the enemy team lead grows, and the bounty is shared with your whole team, regardless of who claimed it. Taking objectives really is the best way to come back when you're behind.
Tak už to řekni, kurva!
We want to help make that a clearer and more rewarding strategy. That said, if a team is really far ahead, objective bounties won't change that. Being the better team should always get you a win. So we'll be watching the new bounty system closely to keep things in check. Finally, let's talk about our biggest addition this preseason, dragons. We really like how each dragon creates
new terrain. Tak počkej, tak ale tak co on řekl ten idiot? On řekl, že bude ještě jeden způsob, jak se vrátí zpátky do hry, kromě shutdownu. Ale on neřekl jaký, ne? Nebo řekl snad? Nebo tohle to je ten druhý způsob? Draci?
Adds more strategy to the mid and late game. So this preseason, we're adding
two more. Něco mi uniklo? Co řekl jako? Odměny za objektivy, tam byl nějaký odměny za objektivy.
Them in by taking map objectives. And this year, we're adding a second way for teams to try and make a comeback. Objective bounties will work like champion bounties, except you cash them in by taking map objectives, like towers or baron. They ramp up slowly when the enemy team lead grows, and the bounty is shared with your whole team, regardless of who claimed it. Taking objectives really is the best.
Takže když jsi behind, dáváš barona, tak za něj dostaneš víc goldů než enemy team, třeba? To je píčo,
way to come back when you're behind. So we want to help make that a clearer and more rewarding strategy. That said, if a team is really far ahead, objective bounties won't change.
Dobrý, ty draky tam dej.
Season. Dragons. We really like how each dragon creates unique terrain.
Silné buffy.
Powerful buffs. And adds more strategy.
No, asi 5% armor a 5% magic resist, boys. Let's go. Ty vole, to je mrdá. Nebo kolik to dává.
So this preseason, we're adding two more. Up first is the Hextech Dragon.
Magi technický
drak.
When
your team defeats it, you'll all gain additional ability haste and attack speed. And if you claim the soul, you'll receive a chain slow that works kind of like Static Shiv's passive. When this dragon takes over the rift, it creates Hextech gates that can transport you to set locations across the map.
To snad ne, ty vole. Takže teleportuje někam jinam na druhém konci mapy? To bude strašný bordel, kámo.
The second dragon joining the party is
temnější sourozenec toho prvního, chemotechnický, ty vole, to byl nějaký Singedův. Jinak magitechnika je spil to hru, vole, jo, lorově. A chemotechnika je ze zónu. Tam je Singed, vole, dělá tam, pouští tam, vole, židům do sprchy něco.
Chemtech tree. When you slay it, your team will deal increased damage when your HP is low, letting you turn around those close team fights. This dragon soul provides a second chance at life. Well, sort of.
Sort of?
You'll enter a zombie state, where you can still cast abilities and continue fighting when you'd normally be looking.
Co třeba udělá Sion? Ten umře třikrát, nebo co?
...at a gray screen. And when the Chemtech Dragon putrefies the map, it creates camouflage zones in fixed locations.
Kamuflážní zóny?
Co?
More impactful than the current ones.
Co to bude jako dělat?
And when the Chemtech Dragon putrefies the map, it creates camouflage zones in fixed...
Když v tom budeš, tak tě neuvidí. Když budeš v tom kruhu, tak tě nikdo neuvidí. Co to je za píčovinu? Můžeš se jenom stát v bázi jak čůrák, no?
No, tak these dragons might seem more impactful than the current ones, and well, they are. Our goal is to add more unique encounters and meaningful strategy to the mid and late game. That said, these are some pretty big changes, and we're ready to adjust if they're making too much, too little of an impact. You can expect to see all of these changes.
To bude vlastně takový velký bush, no, takový obrovský bush to bude jakoby. Akorát to bude kamuflážní, vole, plyn.
Maybe in a couple of weeks, and we'll be looking for your feedback in the months ahead.
Nice, no. Výzvy, co to je jako, co to bude? Jsou skinny?
Outside of preseason, something we've heard from all of you is that you'd like more ways to express yourself and your achievements.
Ty vole, to budou zase Eternals, to bude něco takovýho, ne?
For some of you, ranked is how you define...
Nebudu přidávat další divizi snad.
Progress. And that's great, we don't want to change that.
But no, super.
For those of you who aren't focused on the rank climb, there aren't great ways to express your own progress.
Hmm.
Champion Mastery and Eternals help you show off your skills on a particular champ. But they don't tell the story of your broader League legacy. The new challenges system should achieve just that. Challenges rank up over time, showcasing your increasing mastery and legacy across a bunch of different systems, modes, and gameplay, making it a little different than just a standard achievement. We want to highlight not just your rank and champion mastery, but also your inventiveness. Breadth of playstyle.
Co to kurva je?
Collection and
co za mě je pod těma jménama?
Everything else. Want to showcase your knack for never dying in ARAM? Or how great you are at killing minions in SR in the first 10 minutes? Maybe you've collected over 100 champions or love participating in events. All of this is now possible to track and display your progress with challenges.
Aha, tak já jsem třeba na profil, že jsem nejlepší Lee Sin, že mám všechny čempy a že vole, netrfím žádný kvěčko za Lee Sina třeba, jo? Tak to může být.
You'll get the first glimpse of challenges when they hit PBE next month, and the full system will launch early next year.
Paráda.
That's all I have to share with you today. Thanks so much
yeah,
for watching.
Let's go! Stay next season soon.
Talk-